Environmental problems are complex since they mostly have multiple causes. The severity of the problem depends on a chain of interacting relations. In this clip, I explain how to structure environmental problems using the so-called Dpsir framework. Dpsir stands for drivers, pressures, states, impacts, and responses. The Dpsir framework is a tool for describing and analyzing environmental problems in a consistent and transparent way. It helps you to better structure environmental problems and answer questions such as, what causes pollution problems? And what are the adverse effects? Let's take eutrophication as an example. This problem occurs when there are too many nutrients in the environment. These nutrients come from several sources. Agriculture is one of them. In surface waters, this can lead to harmful algal blooms. Algae can be toxic, and algal blooms can lead to anoxic situations as a result of which fish may die. It is a problem for ecosystems, but also for recreation and fisheries. A problem like eutrophication is caused by a chain of events. I will explain these for bioplastics. The first elements are the drivers. These are the human needs that form the basis of the human activities. In this case, that is the need for packaging materials, such as bioplastics. The second element are the pressures. These are the human activities undertaken to fulfill the human needs. In this particular case, it is plant production and processing the plants into bioplastics. The next element is the state. This refers to the state of the environment. For example, the pollution level of soil, air, and water, and all processes related to this pollution. An example of a state process in this particular case is the nitrate level in the surface water. The impacts are the changes in welfare or well-being of humans, which are caused by the state changes. In this particular case, it is the harmful algal blooms and their impact on society. The final element are the responses. These are the actions undertaken by groups or individuals in our society, or by the government, to prevent, compensate, or adapt to changes in the state of the environment. In this case, these actions could consist of cleanup activities, alternative production, or a change in human behavior. Describing an environmental problem in terms of drivers, pressures, state, impacts, and responses provides insight in the structure of the problem. The drivers, pressures, and responses belong to the societal domain, whereas the state and impacts belong to the environmental domain. This interaction between society on one hand and the environment on the other is typical of environmental problems. It is the playing field of environmental science, the discipline that studies the interaction between society and its environment. Let me now use the Dpsir framework to illustrate the different interventions possible to tackle the problem. Each intervention acts at a different place in the intervention chain. Let's start with one possible intervention, cleanup programs. This intervention acts on the state variable. It improves the state of, for instance, our surface waters. But the effect will be temporary if the causes are not tackled. Moving up the chain, another intervention would be the adaptation of production processes. By increasing the nutrient efficiency in plant production, for example. Moving even further up the chain, we could also try to change people's behavior. For example, by reducing the amount of packaging material used. I'm not saying this is always a feasible or wise solution, but it is important to keep an open mind and ask yourself, what can I do at this point in the chain? At the other end of the chain, the side of the impacts, you can also intervene. An example would be to collect algae from polluted water. Your interventions do not need to be restricted to the boxes of the Dpsir framework, but may also act on the links between the boxes. To summarize, the Dpsir framework can be very useful to describe the causes and effects of environmental problems, and to identify possible solutions. It can be used to analyze environmental problems in a consistent and transparent way, and it can be used as a basis for more detailed analysis of the problem at stake.